Look, it's so interesting in this moment that France is going to be committing, we understand, to a gigawatt of nuclear energy for this AI exuberant moment. You've got leaders of Microsoft, or indeed Andy Jassy just last week, saying it's all about energy that stops us building out data centers, Joseph. What are we not getting about energy needs here?
Well, a data center is nothing more than a bunch of chips and racks that will take models, data, use algorithms to cook together intelligence, answer questions, help people perform economically productive activities. Energy is the flame that powers that process, electricity in particular. And when we look at what the leading hyperscalers and companies want to build, these are immediately going to be some of the largest electricity loads in the United States, and probably the largest class of new generation capacity adding over the next 5 to 10 years.
Joseph, there is a real question about just how much the electricity grid can actually withstand. What do we know about what buy-in we need at the local level? Because a lot of these plans are coming from the federal level, and it's not clear to me that do they actually need more permission or perhaps collaboration with municipalities, states?
So it's important to think about the size of the challenge. We need to hit sort of medium level forecast for how much data center energy we're going to need over the next 5 years. We need to build more generation capacity over that next 5 years than we added over the last 20. It's just a muscle memory that in the United States we don't really have. And that involves everyone from the state and local permitting committees, from local utilities. And there is a role for the federal government in providing some backstops, some funding, perhaps some permitting reform help so that we can get the speed, or we can get power to these data centers with enough speed. The reality is we don't just have a bunch of gigawatt power plants lying around that are ready to plug data centers into.
So give marks out of 10 to the current administration. Apologies, Jackie, entirely my fault. Give marks out of 10 for the current administration.
I think we need to see some more texture around what the current administration wants to do. President Trump has said we're going to open up all the brakes in terms of permitting. We're going to look even to coal plants to rebuild these kinds of things. I think what's really important is what's going to match what the hyperscalers and the companies want to do and what matches what's going on in the power sector now. When we look at what we expect to see over the next few years, the real additions are going to be solar, maybe some wind, batteries, natural gas. I think the administration is in a position to help some of that proceed. Then we need to look at long-term growth, because this isn't a problem that ends in 2030 when the first few mega-sized data centers come online. If this is truly the economic revolution that the companies are investing toward, we need to have a much more ready system for further growth in the 2030s. And there, I think we want to see the administration move toward nuclear power. We need to see investments in modernizing our grid. Those are going to be the key things for long-term progress in the United States.
Joseph, where does this leave climate goals? Because when I hear coal-powered plants, it seems like it's actually taking a step back. And as you mentioned, hyperscalers are involved. What are they going to be amenable to, especially because they have net zero goals themselves? You look at climate security. This is not just a story about the environment, but it's one that has to do with national security. Talk to us about where it leaves these goals.
Of course, there's a lot of considerations that we need to think about, especially as the government gets involved trying to support these mega projects. I suspect that we're not going to see new coal plants built in the United States to power data centers. Instead, where we want to see those hyperscalers want to see investments in clean energy. One of the things that is most helpful in that regard is that they're pretty deep pocketed and they need to spend to build power quickly, but they also want to spend and can make investments in the novel technologies that will allow us to grow this stuff over time. That could be small modular reactors. We've already seen them restarting large nuclear reactors here in the United States. And so the reality of the system today is the more we build, the easier we make it to build, the cleaner and cleaner I think this process is going to be for us.
What's the breakdown of what that share can look like? Because we've heard about nuclear energy kind of for a long time, and I would like to kind of get a better sense of what the horizon actually looks like. Is it a 5-year or 10-year kind of initiative?
We move really, really fast. I think we can make both grid upgrades and nuclear power a part of this solution set early in the 2030s. but a lot of that stuff is still a little bit far from commercialization. It'll take us time to get there. Over the next few years, I don't expect to see much difference in the capacity that's added from what's been added historically. The U.S. builds a lot of solar. The U.S. has large natural gas resources. And the investments we are seeing over the last year and the things we expect to see over the next couple of years are going to combine those two things, combine those two sources principally with some battery storage and some investments in green energy in other places to manage both the emergent power need, the need for stability. You want to run these facilities basically all the time once you've made such a large investment in the underlying chips and data, and then dealing with the climate effects by making investments in renewables and other things.